All right. So this was my first time ever seeing Alien ever. Like, never saw it before. I got to watch it in this movie theater. And I'm just going to say, being able to experience this in a movie theater hit different. Like, these re-releases are pure genius, because the fact that I got to watch this movie for the very first time in a movie theater was an experience unlike anything I think I've ever witnessed before. And I say that about quite a few movies, but like, every movie truly has some sort of experience to show you that you've never had before, if it's that special or that shitty. I mean, either way, you're going to get some sort of experience out of it that you've never had before. But watching this movie here, wow. Like, I can only imagine what it was like watching this movie when it first came out. I'm pretty sure people were terrified. This is a really good movie. Like, this is, wow. And it just brings me to honestly ask the question, what the fuck happened, Ridley Scott? Because now you're making shit like Napoleon, and you're just saving all the shitty stuff for us. I don't understand. Now, House of Gucci, it's mid, but it's decent mid. Last Duel is great. I don't know any, like, the people that shit on Last Duel, I don't really get their problem with that movie, because I thought that movie was great. But Napoleon, buddy, all I know is whatever movie you make next, you better get something close to this, because I've seen Gladiator too, so I know you have it in you. But the Napoleon, you got to stop. No more Napoleons. No more. Make some stuff. Make another Alien movie. I don't know how much you have to do with Alien Romulus, but make another Alien movie. But this is my review for Alien 1979. Yes, 1979 is when that movie came out. So let's do it. 45th annual release, or whatever, re-release. Let's just go to the review. Hey guys, it's your guy in the chair here, and look, this is my review for Alien, starring Sigourney Weaver, Tom Skerritt, Veronica Cartwright, John Hurt, and was directed by Ridley Scott himself. And our story follows a group of astronauts who basically wake up in the middle of their journey home and realize that there is a distress call that they need to respond to. They respond to that distress call and realize that, well, maybe that wasn't a call for help anyway. It was probably a warning to stay away, and they now are dealing with an alien that has infiltrated their ship, and it's not good. It's not, well, it's a great movie. It's not good for them. Like, it's not good for the people who are on this ship. And that is the best way I'm going to describe that plot, because wow. Truly wow. Like, I really got excited at the fact that I get to watch Alien for my very first time in a movie theater. I was so excited for that. I was like, wow, that seems like a really cool thing. Everybody talked about how awesome Alien is. Never seen Alien nor Aliens. The only Alien movie I've seen is, Prometheus, Alien Covenant, and then what else? I think those are all Alien movies I've seen. Other than that, as far as the Predator movies go, which I know those kind of go hand in hand now, I've seen Predators, The Predator, and Prey, but I never saw any of the original Alien movies before, and I was truly in astonishment, man. Like, watching this movie was nothing short of, like, a momentous moment in my cinema going history. Like, being able to experience this in the theaters is different. And one thing I truly have to commend this movie for is the silence. And when I say the silence, you're in space, and so it's very quiet up there. Like, there's not much going on, but this movie kind of highlights how quiet it truly is in space. Like, there's not much sound up there, there's not much going on, and this movie uses that silence to its advantage to be able to emphasize the horror aspects of this movie. I mean, this is true horror we're talking about here. This is a scary ass predicament, not only to be in, but just to face when you see the alien himself. Like, truly thinking to myself, like, what it was like to truly see that alien on screen for the very first time had to be a very horrific experience for so many people when this thing first came out. And I was truly sitting there like, yo, like, this is a nerd's absolute wet dream. This is a sci-fi nerd's wet dream. That's what Alien is. Alien is truly something I did not expect to love as much as I did. Like, this movie was really good. I really have to see the next movie now because, like I said, the silence in this movie truly emphasized and highlighted every bit of just how eerie it is to be stuck in space in an environment like that. And one thing I truly love about this movie even more is the progressive uncertainty and unsureness of this situation itself. How they're questioning each other, like, yo, like, are we really about to, like, just answer this distress call? Like, we're halfway home, now we have to answer this distress call. And it's, I don't necessarily want to go into full spoiler detail, which I'll try my best not to, but it's just, as the movie progresses, and as you fully start to, as you fully start to find out who some of these characters really are and what their purpose was being up there. I mean, one, it was kind of already not spoiled for me, but seeing the other Alien movies, you clearly understand that they are all following a formula, clearly the one that this one started. So I kind of already knew how the formula was going to go. But one thing that this movie does so differently than the others is the atmosphere that they create. It is truly a haunting, just absolute eerie environment they have because they're just so unsure of everything. Once that thing gets stuck on his face, then it disappears. Then you have the little alien pop out of him of his stomach. I mean, watching all that unfold is truly ridiculous. And I've seen it other times. Like I said, I've seen other Alien movies, so I've seen it before, but like watching it be done in this form, in this fashion, it's incomparable. It's truly incomparable. And Ridley Scott truly had an eye for what he wanted to do here. Like, it was truly tremendous the way that he revealed what he wanted to reveal when he wanted to. He didn't have, like, he left audiences in the dark when they needed to be in the dark, and information is provided to you only in the pacing of the movie. Like, it's really hard to guess what the hell is going on, where this thing is going. It's truly a great movie, and one of the characters I loved the most was Ash. Loved Ash, although Ash is a huge dickhead, clearly, but he was one of the best characters because from the very jump, you could tell there was something off about that character. You could tell that there was something just not right going on in his head, and you can tell that there's something bigger going on here that nobody's talking about. But once all the information gets revealed, and once you truly get into the gist of what this movie is, it becomes so sick. It becomes something completely different. And honestly, as far as like the blood and gore and the special effects and the shit they did with Ash's head, and honestly the way that they had the alien popping up and popping out, I'm literally watching all that and I'm like, I can only imagine watching this back in the day was nothing short of spectacular. Like, I literally talked to one of my friends after the movie. He was like, yeah, when I watched that movie for the first time, I literally said to myself, this is possible. It's 2024, and I was kind of feeling like that watching this movie. I was like, yo, all this was possible in 1979? This shit must have looked crazy. I'm like, yo, like, they're really doing some incredible shit with these special effects here. Like, it's really good. It held up tremendously. I mean, clearly in some shots you can tell that it's like an animatronic body of the alien instant doing its thing, but it's like, it truly never took away the terror and just how gross that fucking creature is, like, when it comes full grown. And one thing, once the alien does become full grown and it's starting to do its hunting or whatever around the ship, they truly do a great way of making each moment scary. Like, the movie never loses its scary essence due to the fact that the score is phenomenal, due to the fact, like I said, the environment of being in space and just that silence, that eerie silence up there, it just all adds to the effectiveness of this movie being scary. And this was horror done well, done correctly. Like, jump scares were great, the shots of the alien themselves, what they wanted to reveal to you from about the alien, the just the terror in people's faces, the absolute just what the fuck moments, especially when I'm pretty sure, like I said, I've seen an alien movie before, so I can only imagine what it was like to see the alien pop out of dude's stomach for the first time. But I know that had to have everybody in the theater going, what? Just, And I truly had a great experience watching this film for the first time. This was like going to a seminar or something, and you're learning about a director who was once this great, well-received director or whatever, which Ridley Scott still kind of is. It's just he's definitely had some misses, or at least controversial type of movies nowadays. But it's like, it was like going in here was truly like everything people said about Ridley Scott, everything people said about this movie. I felt like I walked into a museum, got to watch it for myself, and everything that everyone has ever told me about this movie, anything that anybody's ever said about Ridley Scott based off this movie here, was absolutely correct. It was 100% factual. Ridley Scott truly did something that was, I guess, at the time, unimaginable, but now, it's, of course, there are bigger scales, bigger stakes, bigger everything nowadays due to budgets, but what Ridley Scott pulled off in this movie is nothing short of incredible, nothing short of spectacular, nothing short of I was trying to use a bigger word there. Sorry, I got lost. It's Explendid. Is that a word? Splendid is a word. Explendid is not a word. I'm so sorry. Yeah. All right, I guess the alien's kind of fucking with my brain now. Not really. But, look, overall, Alien is a great time. I don't know how long this thing is in theaters for, but if you've never seen it, go do that. If you have seen it, go experience it again, I guess, because I promise you, the experience I had in this movie theater, I know I can't recreate at home. No matter how big my TV is, no matter how surround my sound is. Can't recreate anything like that again. You have to watch that in the movie theater, because that was a one-of-one experience that I am so glad I got to experience. And for all those reasons and so many more, guys, I'm going to give Alien a 4.5 out of 5 stars. All right, so Alien, have you seen it? What did you think about it? Look, guys, thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Be sure to like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff and so much more. Look, this is your guy in the chair. More content coming to you soon.